Hi, this is Dan Wahlin with Interface Technical Training. I'd like to introduce the Web Development with HTML5 and CSS3 class to you and explain some of the different topics that we're going to cover. This class is going to be a really fun class, and here's why. HTML5 is pretty much all the rage these days, but not every technology is quite ready for prime time yet, and you might be confused on what technologies can we use today and what technologies should I maybe wait on until the standard's further along. So we're going to focus on technologies you can use today so that when you leave class, you'll walk out productive and you'll know what's available in all the modern browsers that are out there. So we'll start off with just a really quick look at why we need HTML5 in the first place. And based on all the devices out there, it's a pretty simple answer. It's not just a desktop world anymore. We have mobile phones, we have tablets, and we have desktops, and I'm sure there'll be even more coming down the road. HTML5 targets some of those different environments. Once we get past that, we're going to talk about two key technologies that are free and available for you to use in your HTML5 applications. The first is something called HTML5 Boilerplate. This serves as a really good foundation to base your sites on, and I'll explain what it offers. From there, we're going to talk about something called Modernizer, which is a script library. Modernizer allows you to detect HTML5 features in different browsers. It's one thing to assume that everybody's going to have a modern browser. It's another thing to be realistic and realize we still have older browsers to deal with. And so we'll talk about how Modernizer can be used to do those types of checks. Now from there, we're going to jump right in. We'll talk about some CSS3 features. One of my favorites, it's a very simple one, is we can round corners now very easily without resorting to images or cascading style sheet hacks. We can also go in and do shadows very easily if you need that. So we'll talk about some of the core features in CSS3. From there, we'll get into the HTML5 features, and we'll start off by talking about some semantic tags that are available. Now, semantic tags allow you to, in some cases, replace what we used to use as divs. And we can give our divs IDs and do things like sections and articles and figures, headers and footers, and make our page a little more organized and easy to style with CSS. After that, we're going to talk about things like the Canvas API. This is a pixel-based rendering API that you can use to do graphics without a plugin such as Flash or Silverlight. We'll also talk about audio and video. We'll get into geolocation and even how you can do local storage of data so that if somebody goes out of an app in the back end, you can actually get the data that you had previously. And it's pretty much like cookies, but much more sophisticated, and you can store a lot more data. So we have a lot of fun things to cover, a lot of things that you'll be able to use today in your applications, and I look forward to having you in class.